Welcome to my Bilderberg coverage 2016. It's 120 to 150 people from Europe and North America. It's the political elite, experts from industry, finance, academia, and the media. Pretty much the nicest hotel right there in Dresden. The chairperson of the conference is Henri de Castries. Now, he is the global CEO and chairman of AXA, the largest insurance company in the world. It's based in France. Actually have a really good friend who went to go meet with Henri, and interestingly, as my friend was going into the meeting with Henri, guess who was coming out of the prior meeting with Henri, and that was, of course, the head of Goldman Sachs, Lloyd Blankfein. I'm Sandra Rupp, and I was placed on the Thinkers 50 Guru Radar list for the world's top business thinkers. I've had the privilege of attending the Council on Foreign Relations. I've been placed on the cover of the Davos debates. To attend Bilderberg would be my next dream. Donald Trump had met with Henry Kissinger. Henry Kissinger always attends Bilderberg, so that signaled to me that it's possible that Donald Trump may show up at Bilderberg. And there is a good chance he will be the next president of the United States. And some of you know, I predicted that long before other journalists. I worked in global executive search. I am now an executive coach in Florida, as well as a media commentator. It was established in 1954. It's a not-for-profit organization, but it's been a very sort of behind-the-scenes meeting. I had the privilege, actually, of being a close friend of a man who worked for David Rockefeller. If you talk to someone who attended Bilderberg, they are not allowed to attribute comments to specific people. It's called Chatham House Rules, and you can look it up. I talked about it in last year's video. It means that you can't attribute who said what at a conference, so it is quite hush-hush. According to Wikipedia, the group's original goal was promoting Atlanticism, strengthening U.S.-European relations, and preventing another world war. Okay, so those are really important themes, and I want to commend Bilderberg Group on that. We also know that royalty attends every year. Queen Beatrix of the Netherlands was there last year. Topics ranging from trade to job creation, monetary policy, of course, as well as ecological challenges. I'm sure climate change will be on the list of discussions. They also talk about promoting international security. They want to bolster a consensus around free market Western capitalism and its interests around the globe. Are they trying to, you know, create a one world government? Some say that's exaggerated, but not wholly unfair. There's actually a quote here on Wikipedia. It says, "Those of us in Bilderberg felt we couldn't go on forever fighting one another for nothing and killing people. So we felt that a single community throughout the world would be a good thing." Now, there is some speculation on this because, you know, it's important that we not leave behind anyone. And one of the things I'd like to just observe, after the banks were bailed out in the economic crisis of 2008 in the United States, I think there has been a feeling that Western women are being left behind too much. And I think that this is a really important point for the Bilderberg Group because Western women are the most educated women on the planet. They also have the most years of experience in the corporate world and other interesting business experience. I studied both international business and art at Oxford. I have a Kellogg MBA. I looked up the steering committee. It's on their website. Like the CEO of Lazard, the CEO of Airbus, the head of the PA Consulting Group was there, Evercore. You know, we've got everything from hedge funds to the head of the European Union. In terms of the women, I could only find three. And the thing that that shocked me, actually, these are amazing women, but I think it's important that we have a representative among women from the UK as well as two from the United States. That would be my recommendation. We need to open up a much bigger conversation about the importance of more women on executive row, investing in more women for angel investors, getting more women on boards. Look, Eric Schmidt, the chairman of Alphabet, previously called Google, of course, is there. I love Google, I love YouTube. I actually have my first DVD, it will also be accessible as a video on demand, coming out on Amazon.com this summer. I talk about the 7 steps for success and how I got followers in 65 countries around the globe. I think that if we get more transparency about this conference and know a lot more about it, I think that people will be really happy and we'll create a brighter and better world. It's kind of a delicate topic, but I wanted to discuss it. One of the people that's on the steering committee back in 2009 had written a controversial paragraph in a post at the Cato Institute. Specifically, he calls himself a libertarian, and he talks about how in the 1920s, he felt that was the last decade when one could be optimistic about politics. He said, since then, with the vast welfare programs, and also giving women the right to vote, he said had rendered the notion of capitalist democracy into an oxymoron. Now, I would like to debate that with, if you invest in women, conscious capitalism will bloom. And as you know, I'm a big fan of John Mackey's book on conscious capitalism. I believe that we need to go to the next wave of capitalism, and I believe that women will very much be a part of it. I was placed on the cover of the Davos debates in 2011 when I stated that investing in and empowering the feminine leadership style is the largest economic opportunity worldwide. Because it's very important that we distinguish alpha feminine leaders from alpha masculine leaders. And the combination of the two is really powerful because it creates what I call the yin and yang of leadership. The yin and the yang brings balance to the world. If you look at any tribe of men and women, the alpha feminine women are the ones who are able to tell the men when they've gone too far. There's a lot of discussion about empowering more women through the UN Women Goals. And empowering women in places like Africa and India, and I think that's all necessary and wonderful. We also need to empower the women in the Western countries, and since Bilderberg is a conference about North America and Europe, it's important that we empower, and I would like to be the one that discusses that at Bilderberg, because I think it's probably the most important topic that will help grow this economy and create a better world, because right now, the wealth is in a very small percentage of hands. I'm a big fan of Paul Polman's view of sustainable growth. I would like to be at Bilderberg when he attends, because we got a lot to talk about. Because there are a lot of complex issues coming out of decisions that are being made by mostly male CEOs. I think that we need to make sure we're doing the right thing for women and for men, for children and for adults. Certain media have certain spins on things, and so I actually read about 25 global publications a week because I need to draw my own conclusion. I have only good things to say about Bilderberg, but I would like to see more women attending and more transparency around the topics that they're discussing. And I do believe that the alpha feminine leader voice has a lot to share. They want to foster cooperation on political, economic, and defense issues. We need to take a look at this unemployment figure, not only in Greece, but in the United States, because there are a lot of people who are not counted in the unemployment figure. And now we have robots replacing jobs at McDonald's. I mean, we really need to invest in a lot more solopreneurs and entrepreneurs. If you look at the countries that have outlawed the burqa, there are two in particular, they're the ones who have had a big problem with terrorism. If you're going to let women wear bikinis and even go topless, at the Mayo Clinic in the United States, women can wear their burqas. When you start to tell men how their women can dress, you're going to kind of upset them, okay? I don't think that male CEOs should be telling moms or governors what to do. I think diversity of thought is one of the most important things at these conferences. You know, in 1980, about 20% of Americans worked for the Fortune 500. It's now under 5%. So we need to invest in a lot of the entrepreneurs, including the women entrepreneurs and solopreneurs, because indeed, about 90% of female-founded companies, sadly, are still one-person companies. If we just invest in all of those women solopreneurs, I think we get this economy growing really quickly. About two-thirds are from Europe and the rest from North America. I also would like to see more reporting on it from the mainstream media because I think it's such an important conference. This conference is a little bit under the radar because of its privacy. So some people are concerned about, you know, is there a lack of transparency or accountability? The undisclosed nature of the proceedings has given rise to even conspiracy theories. So you will see the Alex Jones reporters from YouTube at Bilderberg commenting on what could be going on behind the scenes. They try and get into the hotel. They've done a good job of it. It's fun to watch their videos on YouTube, so look for Alex Jones' videos on Bilderberg as well. There will always be people who believe in conspiracies, but things happen in a much more incoherent fashion. When people say this is a secret government of the world, I say that if we were a secret government of the world, we should be bloody ashamed of ourselves. That was a quote from Davin Yong. You can subscribe to my videos at Career Expert on YouTube. You can follow my tweets at Exec Career Coach. You can follow my Davos blog at sandrarep.wordpress.com. I've even started a Davos CEO pledge so that CEOs can commit to bringing two or more female delegates to the World Economic Forum. Be happy to film you. You can have an interview on camera. I'm happy to have you do the final edits if you feel comfortable. I can give you the questions in advance. I'm here to make it a very friendly process. You know, freedom of speech is probably the most valuable gift. Thank you so much for watching. And I am the 11th great-great-granddaughter of the Reverend William Brewster, who came over on the Mayflower.